everybody, welcome to another knitting tutorial with me, Laura, and in this video I'm going to be showing you how to make this cable poncho. Okay, so I'm going to be using a super chunky yarn, so that's a super bulky yarn. That's a yarn weight of 6, and with that I'm going to be using some straight knitting needles, and these are size 10 millimeter. Okay, so it's 10 millimeter straight knitting needles, and the first thing we're going to do is we're going to cast on 100 stitches. Okay, so it's quite a few stitches, so we're going to start off with our slip knot. So hopefully you've been following along with my beginner tutorials on how to cast on, but I'll go relatively slow again just in case. So we create our little slip knot. Just pull that. I'm just going to leave slightly loose there so we can get our other needle in. I'm going to bring in our other needle and we're going to place it through that loop, and it's going to sit underneath the other knitting needle. Okay, so it's going through the loop and it's sat underneath the other knitting needle. Then all we do to cast on is we wrap the yarn round the bottom needle and just pull it so it slips through these needles. And this is the piece of yarn we're going to catch. So we're going to bring our needle down and we're going to catch that yarn that we brought down, and then bring up a loop, and then we're going to place this onto this hoop, onto this needle. But what we need to do is we're just going to twist it. Once you put it out, twist it and then place it on our needle like so. Then we just pull down, and there's our second cast on. But like I said, I've done a video in more detail of how to cast on, so hopefully you're used to doing this already. Okay, so get your loop and then just bring the needle around to the back and then hook that over your needle. I want 100 of these cast on stitches, so cast on 100 stitches. Okay, just catch that yarn, bring up a loop and then just twist it around and hook it on. Okay. So I shall cast on 100 stitches and I'll show you what to do next. Okay, so I've cast on 100 stitches, and you will have to bunch them up a bit to fit them on to your needle, but they should all fit. So once you've cast on 100 stitches, including that slip knot is your first stitch, we are going to work 5 rows, and we're going to start off doing knitting 2, purling 2, knitting 2, purling 2. So knit 2, purl 2, all the way to the end. So we're going to start off with knitting 2. So hopefully you followed my tutorials on how to do the knit stitch and how to do the purl stitch. So we're going to knit 2. It's the same as casting on, but we just drop the stitch. So that's knit 1, then knit another one, and then after you've knitted 2, we're going to bring the yarn to the front. We're going to purl 2. So this is where we put the needle on top, wrapping the yarn round, catching it, purl 1, and then purl 2. Okay, and then we swap back to knitting 2. So we're going to knit 2 and purl 2 all the way to the end, and we're going to do that for 5 rows. Okay, so we knit 2, and if it's too fast, if you're brand new to knitting, do check out my tutorials on how to do the knit stitch in very slow detail and how to do the purl stitch in very slow detail, and then come back to this video and it should make more sense. Okay, so I'm going to knit 2 and purl 2 all the way to the end. I'm going to do that for 5 rows, matching up my knit stitches and purl stitches. So you should always start off with a knit stitch. Even when you do the next row, you'll be starting off with a knit stitch as well. So it's knit 2 and purl 2 all the way to the end for us. Okay, so I'm just coming up to the end of my first row, and I'm just still doing the knit 2, and then move the yarn forward to do the purl 2, and you'll end on purling 2. Okay, so and purl the last 2. So you'll end on purling the last 2, and then when you swap over to the other, to go back the other way, make sure all your stitches, again they're very bunched up, but you'll get used to this. We're going to start off with knitting two again. So you'll always start with knitting two and you'll always end with purling two. And basically, if you lose your way, you just need to do the opposite of what's the other side. So we ended on purling two, so now we're going to knit two. And you can tell which ones are purls because they're the ones with these horizontal bars. So if you get lost as you go across, you're not sure which one needs to be knitted or purled, just see if it has a little purl, a horizontal bar like this, and you know that those two need to be purled as well, because you want to keep the purls the same side and the knit stitches the same side. So these ones here, you can't see them at the moment as well, but if I bring in the finished piece here, which we're going to create two of these, you can see these are the knit stitches and these ones with the horizontal bars are our purl stitches. So we start off with, we start every row with knitting two, and you'll see they'll match up with knitting two here, and then we'll purl two. We're going to do this for five rows. So we've done one row already, so we're going to do four more rows. And we're going to start off with our knitting two. So knit two. And then we purl two. We can see we need to purl two because we've got the little horizontal bars there for our purls. So we're matching up our purl stitches and our knit stitches. I'm going to do that for five rows. Okay, so I shall do that, my five rows, and then I shall come back. And there you go, you can see your purls, you've got your purls together and your knit stitches together. But on the opposite side, you'll have opposite to your knit stitches will be purl stitches, and opposite your purl stitches will be knit stitches. Okay, but we always start with two knit stitches and we always end with two purls. So what am I doing now? Knit stitches. Okay. I'm going to do that for four more rows. We end up with five rows in total. Then back to purl stitches. Okay, so once you've finished your ribbing rows, you should end up with something that looks like this. So you can see that the alternating between purl stitches and the knit stitch creates a ribbing effect. Now we're going to move on to the cable design. So we've done our, it's the right side, we've done our sort of cuff area, our ribbing, and now we're going to move on to this cable stitching. So you're going to need a cable needle, or basically something to hold your stitches. Don't worry about it having to be the same size as your main needle. You can do if you want to, but I tend to just use anything to hold my stitches. So what we're going to do is, first of all, we're going to start a pattern. And our pattern is going to be divided into sets of four. But the first four stitches are going to be purled, and our cables are always going to be worked over knit stitches. And anything in between our cables are going to be purl stitches. So we're going to start off with four purls, and then we're going to knit eight, because each side of the cable is divided into four. So if we have a look at the one here, all the stitches in between our cables are purl stitches. You can tell that because of the horizontal bars. And our cables are all knit stitches. And one side of our cable is going to be four stitches, and the other side is going to be four. So that's why we knit eight. But we're only doing four in between. It looks like more because it's stretchy, but it is only four. So for our pattern, we're not going to do any cables yet. We're just going to start off our pattern. So we're going to start off with our purl stitches first. So we need to make sure our needle's on top, my yarn's to the front, and we're going to do four purls. So knit purl four to begin. So one, two, three and four. So we're going to purl four, and then we're going to knit eight. So if you remember, four, the first four are going to be one side of our cable, and the next four are going to be the other side of our cable. So now ignore the stitches of your ribbing. We're going to create a pattern, different pattern. So we're going to knit eight. Next, one, two, first 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Okay, so we've got our knitted 8, which will eventually become our cable. So purl 4, knit 8, and then we're going to repeat that all the way to the end. So we're going to purl 4, knit 8, purl 4, knit 8, purl 4, knit 8, purl 4. You'll end on purling 4 at the end. It will match the same as this end. So follow that pattern. This is going to be our pattern throughout the majority of our poncho. So apart from when we're going to be doing our cables. So, but we're going to move the yarn to the front and now purl 4. So we purl 4 and then we knit 8. And repeat that pattern all the way to the end. Purl 4, knit 8. Purl 4, knit 8. Okay, so purl 4. It's incredibly hard to do on camera on a table because the knitting needles get in the way. There we go, purl 4. And then move the yarn to the back. And now we're going to knit 8. Okay, so repeat this pattern all the way to the end of your row. This is going to be the front of your poncho. Okay. And then when you get to the end, you should end on purling 4. Okay, you should have 4 left to purl. And if you don't, you have 5, we have 3, then you've obviously miscounted somewhere along the line. We should end on purl 4. And then on the back row, the reverse row, as we're going to call it when we turn over, this is going to be our back, we do the reverse. So because we finished on 4 purl, we're now going to knit 4 and then purl 8. Knit 4, purl 8, knit 4, purl 8. And you'll end on knitting 4 at the end. And then what that does is it makes sure that on the front, all our purls are facing the same direction, all our knit stitches are facing the same direction. So you do the reverse on the back. As you can see here, we knit the first 4, they're knit stitches, and then you can see these need to be purled, these 8 will be purled because they've got the little horizontal bar. So we're going to do a reverse row of what we're doing. I can't even remember, I can't even remember. Knitting the first 4. So we knit the first 4. 1, 2, 3, and 4. And then if you look on the reverse, it keeps our purls to the same side. And then we knit 4, then purl 8. Okay, purl 8. And we repeat this all the way across. Knit 4, purl 8. So it's the reverse. And we're going to do that on every reverse row. So just do that all the way to the end, knit 4, then purl 8, all the way to the end, and you'll end on a knit 4. So how many have I done? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8, and then we're going to go back to knitting 4. So we knit the next 4. 1, 2, 3. I've been attacked by my giant ball of yarn. 4. This yarn's been used so many times, indecisive on what to use it for. So knit 4, then we go back to purling 8. Purl 8. And repeat that all the way across. Okay, so I've just purled 8 and the last 4 are to be knitted. Okay, so we end on knit four on our reverse row. One, two, three, last one, four. Okay, so these are our first two basic rows of our main pattern. Okay, so we turn that over. So this is the main pattern that we're going to follow throughout the poncho. So if I bring in this one here, this is the main pattern we'll be following throughout. So we do two rows of just our pattern. Okay, so that's on the front, we purl four, knit eight. Then on the back, on the reverse row, when we go back, we're going to knit four and purl eight. So now what we're going to do is we're going to do a pattern of a cable row. So that's when we're going to twist our yarn, a cable row, then seven rows of our pattern, just normal pattern. So the next row, we're going to begin with our twisting cable row, and then we're just going to do seven rows of the pattern which we've done for the first two rows. Okay, so let me bring our project in. So now we're on the front row, so we're going to start off with purl four. So we're going to purl four now. You can see that because we've got a little horizontal bars. If you lose track, just look for your horizontal bars, and if they're at the front, then we know we need to purl four, not knit four, to begin with. So let's purl our first four stitches. So one, two, three, and four. So we purl four on our front, and now we need to do a cable twist, and we're going to be working that over our eight knit stitches. So two, four, six, eight are all going to be knit stitches. So you can see there's our next purl. These are all knit ones because you get the little V's underneath. Okay, we're going to divide this into four, so these eight into four. Okay, so we can get that twist happening for either side. What we need to do is to bring in something to hold the first four stitches. So a cable needle or a stitch holder or even a crochet hook will work really well. I prefer these. And we're going to put the first four of these onto our cable needle. So you're just literally hooking them off onto the first four. Okay, so if you're used to cables, you know what you're doing from my other tutorial. But we're going to hold on to those and just drop them. And because we're knitting our cables, we need to make sure our yarn's at the back. And we're going to knit the last four, so the next four. So ignore these down here and go straight into this one here. And we're going to knit the next four. It can feel a little awkward, but this is what creates the twist. And make sure to bring your cable needle to the front, because if you alternate between putting it to the back of your needles or to the front, it will create a different effect on your cable. So whenever you do a cable twist in the whole of this pattern, make sure they're to the front of your work. Okay, so one, next one, two, three, and four. So we've knitted the last four. And then what we need to do is bring these up, and you can either knit directly from your cable needle. What I like to do though is just to hook them back on, especially because they're different sizes. Hook these four back onto my needle, my left needle. One, two, three, and four. Just put that down to the side and just push those on a little bit. It can be a little bit tight doing this, but just make sure you got that needle in the right direction. And we're going to knit these four that we've just twisted over. Okay, so knit the next four. Be a little bit tight. One, and then the next one. Two, and the last one, four. Okay, so what you've basically done is you've knitted those four those aids. You've knitted the next aids, like your main pattern, but you've twisted them. So you've swapped them over, those four stitches either side. And you can't see very much at the moment, but this is the beginning of a cable twist. And then we know we need to purl the next four in between. So we're just going to bring our yarn to the front and purl the next four. And then we do the same thing again. So purl the next four, one, two, three, and four. Okay, so nice normal purls. Put the yarn to the back to get ready for your knit stitches. We're going to do the same thing again. We're going to create our cable twist. So get your cable needle and hook off the first four. One, two, three, four. So we're going to hook off the first four of our next eight knit stitches, and we're going to knit the last four. Okay, so go straight into that fifth one and knit the next four. One, two, once you've knitted those four, don't forget about these. Bring these up, hook them onto your needle, or work them straight from your cable needle. I like to hook them on because I've got a different size cable needle. One, two, three, four. Back down, push these on a little bit, and then bring the needles to the right way around and knit these four. Knit your first four. One. And then we go back to purling the next four. So repeat this all the way across for your cable row. We'll call this a cable row. And so what you want to do is purl four at the beginning and then knit the next eight, but you need to twist them over. You need to twist the four, hook off four, knit the next four, hook the four you've skipped back on and knit those. And then you can start to see these twists coming together. Okay, so I'm going to do that all the way to the end. So now I'm up to my next knit eight. So I'm going to drop off these four onto my cable needle, knit these four, then put these four back on and knit those, so they're twisted, and then I'm going to purl the next four. Repeat that all the way to the end for our cable row, and I'll show you what to do next. Okay, so drop these on. Okay, so just coming up to the end of this row, I've just done my last cable twist, and I'm just going to purl the last four. So you should end on purl four. Okay, so that's our cable row. Two completed. And we'll do our cable row on every eighth row. Okay, it's cable row. Okay, so what we're going to do now is we're going to do seven rows of our pattern. And when I say our pattern, that's at the front we do purl four, knit eight, purl four, knit eight. Then the reverse row, we do knit four, purl eight, knit four, purl eight, so the reverse. We're going to start that now. We're going to start off with a reverse row. So this is going to be knit four, purl eight, knit four, purl eight. We're going to do seven rows of our pattern, starting with our reverse row. Okay, so seven rows of our pattern. So our reverse row, we knit four and purl eight on the reverse rows. Two, three, and four. And the first reverse row, just after your cable twists, can be a little bit tight because obviously you've got this twist going on. But the pattern is the same. Excuse these knots, it's because I've recycled this yarn a lot. So we knit four and then we purl eight. Okay, let's purl eight. One, two, 3. Go back to the knit 4. Let's put our yarn to the front, then we knit the next 4. And you can see that because you've got the little bees. So knit 4. So we're going to do 7 rows of our pattern. So that's knit 4, purl 8 on the reverse, and purl 4, knit 8 on the front. Do that for 7 rows. So I should do that, and then I shall come back. And then basically you just do a cable row again, and then 7 more rows of your pattern. You just keep doing that all the way through. But I'll do my 7 rows and then come back and show you the next cable one again. So I've knitted 4, and then I go back to purl 8. And after you've done your 7 rows, you'll see your twist a lot clearer. Cable twist. Okay, so I've done 7 rows of our basic pattern, and if I stretch this out a bit so you can see it flatter, you can see that the cable that you twist, that you did near the beginning, starts to flatten out and almost comes like normal flat knitting again. So we've done 2 rows of our pattern, and then we did a cable row where we did our twists, and then we've just done 7 rows of our normal pattern. So on the front, that starts off with 4, purl 4, and then knit 8, purl 4, knit 8 to the end. And then on the reverse side, we do the opposite. We do knit 4, purl 8, knit 4. Okay, so hopefully you've got a little something that looks like this. And then what we're going to do is we're going to repeat these last 8 rows. So that's including our 7 pattern rows and our cable row. We're going to repeat that. How many times are we going to repeat that? Going to repeat it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 5 times, 5 more times. Okay, so if we look at this one here, we're sort of at this stage here. We've done our cuff, we've done our first twist, a couple of rows, then our first twist, our first 7 rows. Now we're going to do another cable row, then another 7 rows of pattern. So we do it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 more times, and then we're going to finish up with 1 more cable row, 2 pattern rows, and then we're going to do 5 more rows of our ribbing. Okay, so just repeat the last 8 rows that you've done. So the next one is going to be a cable row, and then do 7 more rows of your pattern. Repeat that, those 8 rows, 5 more times. 5 more times, so you end up with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 of these cable twists, 6 of these, and then we'll do our 7th one at the end. So I'm going to do that, and I shall come back. So again, now we're going to do our cable row. So if you remember, we start off with, at the front, we purl 4 instead of knit 4. So I'm going to purl 4. I'll get my yarn to the front. We purl 4 to begin. Two. Three and 4. So we purl 4 on our, to begin on our front pieces, and then we're going to do our cable row. So we're going to get our little cable needle that you used before, and it's exactly the same as what we did before. We slip off the first 4 stitches onto our cable needle or stitch holder, whatever you want to use. Crochet hook works well too. We slip those off. We're still doing our knit 8, but we slip those 4 off and we knit the next 4. So make sure your yarn's at the back before you do a knit. We knit the last 4. So we're still knitting 8, but we're just twisting it up. So we knit 8. So 1, 2, make sure they stay on your cable needle. three and four. So we knit the last four, we just do it in reverse. And always make sure, like I said, to keep your cable stitches, these ones you pop on your cable needle, to the front of your project. Don't put them behind your needles, keep them to the front for every single cable twist. Otherwise you're going to end up with cable twists that don't look right, so they'll be all twisting the wrong way. So then we just slip these back on to our needle, or work them directly, knit them directly from our needle, whatever works best for you. I like to slip them on because my cable needles are different size to my knitting needles. And then we knit these four. It's going to be a little bit awkward. We knit these four. So we're still doing our knit eight. We're still keeping our pattern, but we're just splitting the knit eight into two groups of four and swapping them over. And then we go back to purl four. So we knit these. Okay. And then we go back to purl four, and then we do the cable twist on the next one. Repeat that all the way to the end, and then we just do seven rows of our pattern stitching. Okay, so I'm going to do that. I'm going to do that five more times, those eight rows, five more times, and then I shall come back and show you what to do next. Okay, so you've got eight rows in total. That's seven normal pattern rows and one cable row. So those eight rows, we're going to do that five more times. Okay, so purl four. So just repeat that to the end and then do your seven rows of normal pattern, and your first reverse row counts as your first row. So you do one, go back, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Okay. So I should do that. And I will come back.
Okay, so I've repeated those steps five more times, those eight rows. So by repeating that pattern, you should end up with one, two, three, four, five, six twists. And what I've done here is I've just done an extra twist row. We're going to do two more rows of the pattern, and then this part of the pattern will be finished. Okay, so I've repeated that five more times, those eight rows, one, two, three, four, five, and that will just get you on a normal pattern row. Then I've done one more row, a cable row. I've just done a cable row there, so that's our last twist. And then I'm going to do two more rows of just the pattern. Okay, two more rows. So I've done my cable twist row, then I'm going to go back, I'm going to go back one more time. Okay, it's two more rows. I'm just going to do that. Then we're going to finish up doing five more ribbing rows, and then we're finished. We'll just need to join it together. Okay. Okay, so I've just done two more rows, and you should end on a reverse row. So that's the back. So if I bring it over to the front, I don't know if you saw my little elves there. That's on my crochet channel, coming soon. But it should look a little something like this. So we've done five rows of the ribbing, then we did two pattern rows, so that's doing the four purl, then eight knit, four purl, eight knit. We've done two rows, and then on the reverse we do the opposite. We do four knit, eight purl, four knit, eight purl. So we've done two pattern rows, then we did our first cable twist row, then we did seven pattern rows. So that cable twist row and seven rows, those eight rows are going to be like one set. So we've done one, two, three, four, five, six. Six sets in total. Okay, so after I showed you those first rows, those two and then those next eight, then you repeated that five more times. One, two, three, four, five. Then we finished up with another cable row and then two more pattern rows. Okay, so it should look a little something like this now. So neatened off, you've done a cable twist and two, one, two pattern rows. And what we're going to do now is we're going to do five more rows of the ribbing. So I'm just going to set up my camera and then I'll just re-show you how to do the ribbing again in case you've forgotten.
Okay, so we don't need to follow our pattern anymore. We're going to go back to doing the ribbing, and when we did the ribbing, we always started off with a knit stitch. Doesn't matter what row you're doing, a reverse or a front row, we always start off with knitting, so a knit stitch. So we do knit two, it's as simple as this. We just knit two, so one and two. We knit two, then bring the yarn forward and we purl two. So
to be purl too. So ignore your pattern now, your cable pattern, we're going back to ribbing. Purl two. And then we just repeat that all the way across. So then we put our yarn back and we go back to doing knitting. So ignore the stitches you got here. It doesn't matter if they're purl stitches. We need to do knit two. One and two. And sorry about my big knot coming along. Knit two and bring the yarn forward again and we purl two. We're going to repeat this all the way across, doing knit two, purl two, knit two, purl two, all the way to the end. I'm going to do that for five rows, okay? So five rows, and we always start off with a knit stitch. So when you're doing your next row, you'll also start with a knit stitch, and you'll see it corresponds as you go along. So, okay, so knit two, purl two. So I should do that all the way across. Do that for five rows. Okay, so I'm just coming up to the end of the first row, and I'm just doing, you should end on two purl, so you should do two purl at the end, one and last one, two, and because you end on two purl, that's why you always start with a knit stitch, because on the next row, because you did purl last, you're going to start with a knit stitch. So there we go. So you can see these two are purls, so these are going to be knit stitches. So you always start with two knit, and you go knit two, purl two, knit two, purl two. You need to do that for five rows. So I'm going to do this four more times, and then that's pretty much it. So knit two. Okay, so I finished those five rows, and all that's left to do now after our ribbing is to cast off. And we're going to follow the same pattern that we've been doing for the ribbing in our cast off. So again, we're going to start off with knit two, and we're going to purl two, knit two, purl two. But we're going to cast off as we go. So we'll start with two knit stitches. So I'm going to knit two, one. And we're always going to be working with two stitches. So we're always working with two stitches when casting off. And when we've knitted the first two, we need to cast off. So we're going to put our hook into our first stitch. Now hopefully you've been watching my cast off video and this isn't too new to you. We're basically just going to pull the first stitch over the second stitch. So, and a little trick to make sure that it's easy to do is just to pull on your yarn as you do it, and that just keeps that a little bit tighter on your hook. So we just pull that over the first one and then drop it, and then we've got one stitch left, and that's our first cast off. Now, as you can see here, we're onto our two purls. So what we're going to do is bring our yarn forward and we're going to purl the next stitch, but only the next stitch, because we only work with two stitches at a time. So we're going to purl the next stitch, and then we do the same thing again. We just pull the first stitch over our second stitch. So again, you can just pull on that just to keep that on your hook. And then we just pull that over that stitch, and then we drop that one and we leave that one on our hook, on our needle. And then we can see the next one is another purl, so we're going to purl the next one as well. Oops, not camera. So we purl the next one and we do the same thing again. So we're just going to put our hook into the first one, just put on that to keep that on our needle. And then we're going to just pull that over, push our needle up and drop that off. Okay, and then we're back to knit two. So we need to bring our yarn to the back and we're going to knit the next stitch. We're going to do this all the way across. So we're keeping to the knit two, purl two, but we're only working with two stitches at a time and casting off as we go. Okay, and then again, the next one is a knit stitch. So we knit that and then we cast off by putting this stitch over the second one. Okay. Drop that off. And then we're back to purl two. So we bring the yarn forward. So we're going to do this all the way across, casting off as we go. And then our piece is finished. So I shall do that and then I shall come back. Okay, so I'm just coming up to the very last stitch and I'm ending on a purl stitch, just like the ribbing pattern. So purl the last stitch. You end up with your last two stitches and it's exactly the same.
We just put our hook in the second one. We pull it over the first one. That leaves us with one stitch. So what do we do at the very end? Well, we cut our yarn. Going to cut our yarn here. Move that out of the way. And then what I do is I just feed the end of this yarn through the last loop. Okay, I pull my needle out. So this yarn's gone through the last loop, and then I just pull, and it just creates a little knot on the end, so it won't undo.
There we go. So hopefully you've got something that looks a little something like this. You've got your ribbing, five rows of ribbing this end, and then you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 cables. We end on 5 ribbing at the end, and we've cast off, and you can see it makes a nice, by doing the knit purl, knit 2 and then purl 2 cast off, it just creates a nicer edge. It just follows the pattern. Now what we need to do is you need to make 2 of these, so you're gonna have to do all these steps again to make another one of these, so you end up with 2 of these little mini throws. And then what we're going to do is we're going to join these together and turn them into a poncho. So that's what we're going to do now. Okay, so this is quite difficult to show on camera, but I wanted to show you obviously how to put it together. So hopefully you've got 2 of these mini little blankets now, and we're going to put them together to turn them into the poncho. Now this is a good time if you've got a mannequin, fantastic. If you haven't, then do try and get someone to help you out and figure out how to put this together. So what we've got here is we've got this going long ways over the shoulder, and it stops literally just over the top of the shoulder. So this is the short edge down here of one of the pieces. So cables are going horizontal, and that's just over the top of the shoulder. So that's the short edge, and then the long edge with the ribbing is coming down the front here. And the other piece needs to have the short edge this side, and that wraps around long, goes all the way around the back and joins up to the short edge here. So you've always got the ribbing next to a non-ribbed edge. So the short non-ribbed edge is going against the ribbing here. So hopefully you can understand how this is put together. So we've got a long piece over here stopping on the shoulder, and then we've got it going just over the shoulder and then round the back in long ways as well. So what is nice is you end up with the ribbing going around the neck. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to sew, I've crudely pegged this together, I'm going to sew this piece together here. So this is one end of the ribbing and one short edge. I'm going to sew that together. I'm going to do the same for the other bit here around the back, where we've got this short edge along with the ribbing, the end of the ribbing edge. So the short edge of this one is all the way down the bottom down there. So I'm going to join these together, sew these together, and show you the final poncho. Okay, so I've laid this down, I've just taken it straight off the mannequin, and I've laid it down on my table, and you can see what you should end up with is this will be the gap where your head goes, with the ribbing that goes all the way around. And if you literally turn this over, you would end up with the same format. So this is the long piece going across here, and it just folds over and stops there. And then this one, it's just a little bit here that folds over to this side. So if I turn this over, it'll look exactly the same. So you end up with exactly the same thing. You've got the long piece and it's connected here and just here. So it's identical. So I'm going to sew along this edge and this edge. And I think I'll write this up on my blog as well, with some sketches. Hopefully you can understand how to put this together, and I'll come show you the finished poncho.
Okay, so I've cut myself another piece of the same yarn I've been using to knit this with, and this is double the length of the piece I need to sew. So it's just double the length and a little bit more, and that should be more than enough to be able to sew across this end. So what I'm going to do to sew this together is thread this onto my yarn needle. And I'm going to find the first stitch along this ribbing, so we've got proper stitches along this ribbing. So I'm just going to go into the back stitch only. So you've got two loops, got little V's going across the top here. I'm just going to go into the back loop, and this will keep a nice edge on the front. I'm just going to go into the back loop. So this is the right way, this is the front, so I've got wrong sides together. And then I'm just going to try and sew along this as neatly as I can. So we should have sort of have stitches along this edge anyway for the rows. So I'm going to follow those as best I can. Okay, and I'm just going to do quite simple stitches. A bit of a tail. I'm going to go through that first one twice. Then I'm going to find the next stitch, and again, go into the back loop only. Find the next one here, and I'm just doing the same thing again. I'm just going into the front loop of the opposite side. So we've got like little, sort of like little stitches on this side. So I'm just going to go into the front loops along here and just see what that looks like. You can experiment with how you join this, see what looks best. And then again, back loop this side, and then front loop-ish this side, as neatly as we can. Okay, so back loop. And find front loop as neatly as you can. So I'm going to do that all the way across this edge, and then I'll do the other side, and then that should be it really. We'll have a look and see what it looks like. Okay, so I've sewn along this edge. It's quite actually okay along the cable edge because you've got sort of almost like proper stitches this side as well. It's only the ribbing on the end where you don't really have anything to sew into. So I've just done it as neatly as I could. I'm going to hide my tail ends, and this is what it looks like at the end. So it's quite neat. I'm going to do this for the other side, and then it's finished. And there we go. Just put it on the mannequin, like so. And what's really nice about this is you end up with the ribbing all the way around the neckline as well, so that's a really nice finish. And you can add tassels if you want to down here. But I hope you've enjoyed that tutorial. I hope you've managed to follow along, and I'll write this up as well with some diagrams on how to put it together, and that'll be on my blog. I'll put all the links in the description below when they're ready. But I'll see you soon for some more knitting fun. Thanks for watching, guys. Bye.
And there we go. I thought I would just show it to you on a real person so you can have a look. So I hope you enjoyed that tutorial, hope you managed to follow along, and I will see you soon for some more knitting fun. Thanks for watching, guys. Bye. Thank you.